come to the end. One word in your head, how do you describe that feeling? You first, Nikki.
Can it be done with an expression? Because that's my expression.
Okay. And why? And why?
Do you want to hold hands?
Oh, how about you?
Love.
One word. Love.
Love. That's a good one.
Why?
You know, it's this has been a project that has really spoken to love in a lot of aspects. It's uh-huh. about, you know, when you love someone and that love is eternal, you know, uh-huh. like how far you're willing to go to fight for that.
Uh-huh.
When you can live forever, what do you live for? It was the original tagline of Twilight, and I always
knew you stole that from somewhere.
Oh yeah, no, that's Twilight. That's like used to be on all the billboards, and I thought that was fascinating. And here we are at the end, and love is really what brought us here. Mm. The fans love the series, mm. and here we see all these characters in this final installment really fighting for what they love.
Yeah,
and I think that's what it's all about.
Very poetic. What is life after Twilight like? I mean, you know, you've been busy with a lot of films, a lot of indie films, and you with your production company and everything. What is Twilight like after? I mean, what is it like after Twilight?
Well, we haven't really said goodbye to Twilight. As mm-hmm. you can see, we're here right now, and we wrapped a year and a half ago.
Yeah.
But in the course of that, you know, we've had an entire mm-hmm. film. Part one has come out. We've traveled the world promoting that, and now we're here for part two. So I don't really feel like I know what life after Twilight is like mm-hmm. yet. And I don't know if it will ever be life after Twilight. I mean, I feel like this is sort of always going to be a part of our lives and careers to some degree. You know, you're not closing a door and it's like you'll never see it again, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, Twilight if you define the word Twilight, it actually describes that moment as the sun is setting and as the sun is rising.
Mm-hmm.
It's basically the way where that light kind of creeps across.
Mm-hmm.
It's true, you should look it up.
Yes.
And so, you know, there is that side that there is, you know, the day is ending.
Mm.
And the night is coming, but there's also a new day arriving.
Mm.
And
so has it gotten easier, harder in terms of, you know, getting the roles now that, you know, or sort of trying to break out of the whole vampire?
I think people want to hear that once you're in Twilight, you know, everything is available to you and there are no challenges and it's, you know, you're just a superstar. It's just not the case. You know, I feel, especially being a woman in this industry, I feel like you have to fight, I mean, you know, for you as well, for everyone, but you have to fight really hard to prove yourself and you have to win jobs and, you know, directors, especially, you know, creative ones, the talented ones, they're not going to cast you based on, you know, the fact that you're in something that was as large as this series. They want to see you in a room. They want to be won over by you. So I've found that, you know, I've had to work really hard, and this year has been a phenomenal year for me, and I'm really excited about all the projects I have going on. But it's also been, you know, I've sat here for many years prior to that and had nothing to talk about, you know, so.
How about you, Jason? You were born in Singapore. You know, so obviously Singaporeans have a very special connection with Jasper. Any special memories of the place?
Of Singapore?
Yeah.
I wish. I was born there and promptly left when I was like a week old.
Oh, okay.
So I was very much only born there. My older sister and I, Kelly, we're both born in Singapore, but our parents lived in Indonesia at the time. So
okay.
I haven't been there much. I'd love to come back though an invitation.
You got birthright there.
Yeah, right. Yeah, come on.
But that brings me to the fact that, you know, it's so global, the whole entire vampire mythology. And forgive the pun, but, you know, obviously it exploded with you guys. It's always been around, but it sort of exploded with you guys. And now that it's sort of coming to the end, do you think vampires will live forever? Or, you know, will the trend die down?
I don't know. I don't know what the recipe for success is. I don't know if it's... I know that right now it certainly feels like a very hot topic, but I don't... Possibly. I feel like the vampire genre, you know, began a long time ago, and we are just sort of adding our take on it, and I'm sure it will continue, because it's much greater than just Twilight, you know?
Mm. Yeah, I think what Stephanie Myers was able to do is create her own version, her own mythology within the vampire genre, and she romanticized it in a way that really resonates with people worldwide. And, you know, it's a story about love. And that's what matters to me.
Word again, love. Thank you very much.
That's me bookending it.